Welcome to Sweet 16 coverage of the NCAA tournament on CBS Sports. Today's game is between the Memphis Tigers and the Connecticut Huskies. To make it this far is an incredible accomplishment. There's the bracket, and there is the starting lineup for each team.
Thus, we should really pay attention to the matchup in the middle. These two centers are really skilled and demand your attention on the court. Expect a big game from both of them.
And let's have a look at the keys to the game for these teams here today.
If they can get these things accomplished, they're going to have a good shot at the win today.
And we're off and running into the first half.
They come out in a minute.
Out on the right wing. Thanks for joining CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. I'm Gus Johnson alongside Bill Raftery. The Huskies set up four around one.
That's tough because guys can make shots and yet they can penetrate and kick.
They work the perimeter. With 10 to shoot on the shot clock. At the top of the arc, and he can't get them out. Cleans the glass. Duren handles the pass. Shots up. Shots off.
Great strength.
Cole handles the feed. Coach, we're about midway through the first half. Good ball game. Both teams look like they have a chance to win this thing.
I think both teams are executing well. Ultimately, it's going to come down to who is going to play tougher at the defensive end and rebound the ball.
Dump it inside. Fires. Shots off. Takes the board. Cole receives the ball. With a big shot, the senior. The first half is in the books. The road to the Final Four is up next. And here is our game summary.
We've seen a lot of action and some impressive play here today. A look at these numbers can give you an idea of who has been doing what.
Here's a look at how both teams are doing with their keys to the game. All right, Bill. We're going into the second half. This could potentially be the last half of basketball for one of these teams. It's all at stake. It's time to leave everything out on the floor.
You know what I think is really impressive here tonight, Gus? Is the fact that both of these clubs are focused on each possession. The level of concentration is where you'd expect it to be during the tournament.
Outside, Jay won't go.
It's all about shot selection, Gus. It's so important to take good shots. And not necessarily the shot the defense wants you to take.
Jump shot. He can't get the bucket to fall. Jackson receives the pass. Ball is saved. Great job. Ball's going to stay here. Offensively, they'll set up from the sideline. Cole gets the ball. Fires.
Squared up on the catch. Got his puppies in order.
Harris turns it over. Martin receives the ball. Raf, everything we could ask for. Close game in the first half. Still close here in the second half. What a bowl.
Well, my gut tells me that this one is going to come down to coaching on both sides. I think the coach's strategic maneuvers here are going to be the big difference. Making sure that the star players are getting the ball in the right place will be huge. The game, it's about managing the clock and getting the most out of your offensive possession. A few stops and a few scores could seal it.
Jackson handles the pass. Now it's all about clock management, Bill. Stopping the clock in hopes of getting the lead.
Trying to sneak their way back in.
Out of bounds, and we're staying right here. Baseline inbound.
Clock management, Gus, that's what it's all about now. Stopping the clock in order to get back into this game.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. They'll throw this one in from the side. And, of course, another foul as they try to remain close.
Not much else they can do.
And yet another stoppage, and yet another foul.
And why not?
Ball coming in from the sideline. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Good strategy.
Sideline inbound. And, of course, another foul as they try to remain close.
Much else they can do.
Here's another solid junior, Bill.
By the time you're a junior, you know what your coach expects from you. It's about leading by example and guiding the younger players on the team.
He missed it.
Big time presentation at the rim. He made himself bigger by extending his arm.
And we're back, ready to get things going again after the timeout. The Tigers now running a zone offense.
The impact very similar to their man-to-man. They find the open guy.
And he misses the shot. And yet another stoppage and yet another foul.
Why not?
Another great second-year player here, Bill. Underclassmen are a big key for any successful program.
Gus, he's young, but he's been through his freshman year, and he's learned a lot. This is going to be another big season for him. Let's see how he does today.
And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. The Tigers set up into their zone motion offense.
And this is difficult because they understand how to take advantage of mismatches.
Well, Bill, sometimes statistics lie, but in NCAA tournament basketball, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going on.
Well, when you take a close look at this victory, it came down to execution. We say it all the time, but these guys did a terrific job of getting stops at the defensive end and scores at the offensive end.
All right, that's a wrap for my partner, Bill Raftery. I'm Gus Johnson saying good night.